Right. We are going to throw lamp base in two parts today. 2 5.5-pound pieces of clay are joined together after they're partially thrown, and we'll shape them into our final product. This is my taller lamp. The other day I showed you the small single piece lamp base that I did. So I think one of the most important things in throwing these tall cylinders in two parts is that you keep it nice and smooth and straight. No thin parts, no thick parts. Nice consistent shape. First of all, we'll get our cylinder and start it here. We'll put a bottom on it. That's the normal thing to do. And we'll give it a nice claw pull over there. Always going toward the center. Because that way, you don't have the force of the spinning wheel pushing it away from the center. Now we'll give it one more pull. Now I'll put a little lip on it. Pull the top piece. Okay, there's our cylinder. So I'm going to make a little here. Pull the center part up real thin, because after we join it together, we don't want a thick piece of clay here. We don't want a lump in our front, because that'll show up in the finished piece. So I'm going to brush it off a little bit. Just grip that up. Notice I've got a flat base for the next piece to sit on, and a tapered flange here. So I've got a little leeway by tapering the flange, and it makes it easier to attach. Okay. So now, an important part that I've learned that makes things easy is to mark my bat holder here with the vertical line, and then mark where my bat meets up with it. So when I put that back on the wheel, it will be centered for me. I won't have to fool with it. Now this one, we're not as worried about having the bottom be a little thicker than the top, since that will end up being the top of the piece. So we're going to try to pull the bottom of this form up a little more, so we don't have so much shape, no, not shape, and so much throwing to do. Once the two pieces are together, we'll just be shaping it. Maybe you want to know where this cool apron came from. Well, it was made by Jen Swearington of Jen Crafts. It's very nice, nicely done out of heavy denim. And it has adjustable waistband. And the strings continue up the sides to the top. And it does for it. I'm trying to do this fast, not to bore you. But I do want to do it in real time. I don't like those videos that aren't, ones that are speeded up to get through the process quickly. And I don't like those very much. I just remembered something I forgot to do, which is to measure the size that this piece will fit on top of. Where they join together, they're on the same size. Yeah, that's nice. We'll leave just a little bit more clay up here, because this will be an area that we're going to stretch out a little further once we get them together. Okay, so I'll measure this as we did if we were making a lid. So this, I want this to fit tight. Oh, it's a little too big. So we're going to have to collar that in, which I'd rather not do. It off because we're going to have to lift this piece up to put it on top of the other piece. That way we'll dry our hands also, and that way it will adhere to our hands without having to dent the shape, distort the shape. That's good. Let's take the water out of that so it doesn't come flying out at us. And we can square this one a little bit if we like too. Notice I've left the top a bit flat also. So it'll meet well on the other cylinder. And I'll just cut that one off a little bit. I think I cut it off. Put it aside. Bring the base back over and find my mark. There it is. Center, voila. Okay, so now I'm going to dry my hands so I can pick up the other piece. Which... better stop the wheel. Get up here on my little pedestal. Slip it right on top. Doesn't look like much now. First thing I'm going to do is fasten it. I'm going to finger up against the little flange I made and push out on it and hold the outside with my rib. There we go. That should do it. Then I'm going to straighten it out a little bit. Pretty thick. I like to have a thick edge on these where the lid goes on and at the top of the lamp base. If it doesn't fit the way I want it to, I could always take some off of it. Because you're going to add glaze to both surfaces, so they will be glazed together. Thin this top part out here a little bit. Make it a little bit taller. Also make it easier to collar inward and make it a little narrower. Okay, so now we're going to go down and start expanding that belly there. Inside is lubricated, so my fingers slip up the surface. Scrape some clay off of there too. That's my favorite tool, this metal rib, because I could bend it into the shape that I want my form to be and then just use my inside hand to go across it. As I move the rib up, I like to do this in a steady motion. That way you get the smoothest profile. Expand it a little bit there in the middle. Bring it back in. Let's go ahead and call it on top a little bit. Usually I like the wheel going faster for that. This tall form, I don't like it to go very fast. So as we collar it in, we're making it thicker, so we'll be able to pull a little more clay there. A little taller again. Always flatten that at the top. Keep that true. Okay, so let's put another little more shape into it. So neck. Yeah, I like this rib. Sometimes I've used this large wooden rib on the outside, which works very nice too, because it has such a long straight surface area, you can just pull it up and turn it. Let's show you how we do that one. And what I'm doing is I'm not pushing into the clay, I'm pushing out to the rib. Let's try to get that center a little neater. Right in here where the pieces were joining. Always takes a little extra caution, a little extra effort in there. And getting around it. Profile. Yeah. Little flat spot right there where I change directions. Straighten that out. And I think we're there. Got a little water in the bottom to remove. It up from the back there. With a little homemade tapered stick. Let's show you that. There's the two of them. Two down. One more to go.